Dreamhouse Biodigesters. In this video, I'm going to show you the 7 quick steps to installing and constructing a biodigester. We are going to use the standard family size biodigester as a test case and install a simple on-site biodegradable waste biodigester. If you are new to this channel, we do videos that make you understand and learn how this amazing new technology works. So if you are new to this channel, you might want to consider subscribing. We are also active. We have a website, dreamhousebiodigesters.com. You can go there, read some of our articles, latest articles, and then watch some of our videos there as well. You might also consider following us on Instagram at dreamhousebiodigesters. Let's go into the video now. Step 1. Site selection and preparation. The first step is obvious. Select the site and location for biodigester construction. Site selection and location of biodigester is usually done after the site has been inspected and assessed. Preferably, this should be done in agreement with the plumber, who usually does the final connection, and of course the homeowner. Siting of a biodigester should take into consideration both soil type and water table condition. Ideally, a biodigester should be sited in a well-drained location, typically with subsoils that are sandy, so that the digester can be placed totally and firmly in the ground. Siting of a biodigester should reflect the highest water table condition that one will find in the location and immediate surroundings of the biodigester. How do you determine this? By digging a hole and observing the saturation depth of the area you are going to work. When the water table during severe conditions is below 4 feet, the digester can be installed at full depth, leaving less than 1 foot exposed above the ground. For example, if the water table is high, the site consideration determines that the digester should be lowered to the ground only a few inches. In this case, the front of the digester hole should be a few inches deep and the back of the digester hole should be 6 inches to 8 inches deeper than the other. Step 2. Mark and dig ground based on size of biodigester to be installed. Mark and dig the ground based on the type of biodigester you intend to construct or install. For example, 2.5 feet width by 5.5 feet length for the standard family size biodigester. If you intend to do a bigger digester for a larger number of users, then by all means increase the size. But for the average Ghanaian family, the standard family size will do just fine. Let me add this quickly though. In locations that are not ideal, like waterlogged areas, the installer must place the digester at a depth so that it will never be below the water table, even during the raining or wet season. Click on the link above to watch my video on how to install a biodigester in a waterlogged area and what to look out for. Step 3. Dig rectangular shaped digester bed hole with depth depending on required slope for plumber. Remember, after agreeing with the plumber for the location, you are also supposed to agree with the plumber for the depth in which the digester must go. If the homeowner intends to do filling in the house, then obviously you are supposed to do the digester at an angle or at a depth whereby it will still show up a bit for the final floor, tiling, or pavement blocks laid. So I will reiterate again, the type of digester to be installed will usually be determined by the number of users of the facility. So if it's a 3-bedroom house, a 4-bedroom house, a 5-bedroom house, or even a bigger property. And also the digester hole should be rectangular and big enough to hold at least a 2 feet by 5 feet digester. It's important the base of the digester hole should have a slight pitch toward the back of the hole, with the back end being about 6 to 8 inches deeper than the front end. If you are interested in learning how to install a simple on-site biodegradable toilet, then click on the link below. It will take you to our store. There's a downloadable PDF guide that you can download and watch the video and learn how to install this new amazing technology. Now to step 4, which is the soak hole construction. You will have to prepare a water drain area for soak pit, which is the soak hole construction. The soak hole, as we have determined for biodigesters, is a circular hole that is dug between the digester bed hole, right? A 4 feet long pipe or a 4 inches long pipe will connect the bottom back of the digester with the soak hole. Out of the back of the digester bed or the digester hole, you are required to dig a 2 to 3 feet long trench, which is wide enough to hold a leachate pipe, which is usually between 3 inches and 4 inches in diameter. I prefer you simply use the 4-inch pipe just to allow for enough wastewater to pass through, depending on the users as well. This hole should be as deep as the digester bed hole. Then at the other end of the trench hole, you dig a circular hole that can start from 2 to 3 feet in diameter, and that will serve as the soak hole. Now the depth of the soak hole, or the bottom of the soak hole, should be 2 feet 6 inches below the bottom of the leachate pipe hole. I hope you get this one. Because you are going to do screeding inside the digester bed, the slope of the water will have to come out through the leachate pipe and then go into the soak away or the soak hole pit, right? So it means that the bottom of the soak hole pit will always be about 2 feet 6 inches deeper to allow for enough gradient and slope for the water to come and go inside for the filtration to happen. Now in terms of filling the soak hole, you will be required to fill the bottom of the soak hole with first a layer of large rocks. Each rock should be about 3 inches in diameter, and then you can also use broken blocks for filling the soak hole, since they also absorb water very well. There are some places when you go and then you are doing the digester, you will find it difficult taking along stones, or you're getting nice stones to fill the digester bed. So if there are broken blocks around, you can collect some of them and use it to fill the bottom of the soak hole. They also work well. And then filling the soak hole, remember, allows for easy penetration of the filter water. So when you're filling the soak hole, remember, first large rocks, then cover the large rock with a layer of smaller rocks. And then after the smaller rocks, you can, if there's some chippings, you can collect some of the chippings and then put them on top of the smaller rocks. Line the inside of the soak hole with a piece of recycled plastic. The plastic should cover the rocks and go up the sides of the hole slightly. The top lining ensures that rainwater does not seep into the soak hole to allow for easy penetration of the wastewater from the digester. on top of the plastic lining, then sew the soco with the same topsoil that you was dug out. And because the soco is buried, it's always preferable, it's done such a way that nothing will come and block it, which will prevent the water from coming in as it is required. 50 to 45 of them. And if it's a large digester, you might need as much as 80 pieces of blocks. If it's precast slabs, you will just have to arrange them, use the binding wire that's already in the fabricated slabs, twist them and hold them firmly to hold the digester firmly together. And then you will use mortar to seal all the joints. And then in some cases, in terms of the screeding, you must do a screeding that will lead to the so-called pit where you have put the shape pipe. In some cases, you will have to do the screeding and wait for it to dry well before laying your blocks to support the digester bed. Step 6. Prepare and fill the digester bed with filtration material, which will be a multiple layers per instructions. This is where, if you have the manual, you refer to the manual, the downloadable manual, which I will give a link at the bottom of this video for you to go and then get your copy if you've not already bought one. So the digester bed, you set it up with a wire mesh. Then it means that you lay the wire mesh across the blocks and cement ladder blocks into the place. There are some instances we use poros made of chippings and cement in place of the wire mesh. What happened with this was that most of the government projects, it was agreed that poros will last better than the wire mesh, because the wire mesh, after a time between 2 to 3 years, will corrode because of the acidic water coming from the digester. So then the poros chippings were a better option, and then most people now use the poros chippings in place of the wire mesh. You can also do that, but you can go back to the basics and still use your wire mesh, and then knowing that your bad digester, when done properly, will last you 2, 3, 4, or 5 years, and then the maintenance work will have to be done, and the replacement of all the materials inside the digester bed will have to also be replaced. It means that then the wire mesh will work fine in any situation, right? So the next thing is to line the digester bed with 2 layers of fiber net or mosquito net. You place it directly on top of the wire mesh or the poros. Now you lay the sawdust, your hay or fiber. What we sometimes we do is to add the sawdust, treated sawdust, and then we add the fiber, coconut fiber, on top of it. So we add about 3 to 4 inches layer of hay or fiber or sawdust on top of the mosquito netting or the fiber netting, and then add coconut fiber to help aid the microorganisms in their biodegradation process. There are some cases you can add organic manure or compost if necessary. So with that, you add a 3 to 4 inches layer of rich compost or organically rich topsoil on top of the coconut fiber or the hay. The hay is usually the green grass that are cut and dried that the horses usually feed on. When you get that one, it works well because microorganisms can easily be generated from it and they will aid in the decomposition. Again, be sure to cover the entire bed, including all the top corners. And the last step, which is step 7, is to put the top slab and cover to seal the digester. In this case, you can also decide to put an inspection chamber outlet if necessary. In some cases, when you have a problem or you are called to come and do maintenance or check if the digester is still working well, you don't want to go and break all the sealings that you have done on the digester. So if you have an inspection chamber on top of the digester, you only open it up and look inside the digester if there's water inside or it's working well. It's not necessary to place a vent pipe on top of the digester. There's a video, I'll give the link up there, where you can see why you don't need a vent pipe on your biodigester. and then you can also make sure that the surrounding of the digester is filled to the desired level, allowing the homeowner or those who are working on the site to secure the digester and then add landscaping to the digester area, right? So basically this is what you do when you follow all these steps. Then your biodigester is done and then you are in safe hands. Thank you. If you are interested in learning how to install a simple on-site biodegradable toilet, then click on the link below. It will take you to our store. There's a downloadable PDF guide that you can download and watch the video and learn how to install this new amazing technology. Thank you for watching once again. Next time, bye bye.